Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with retired Chief Deputy Rod Englert. His book is Blood Secrets, Chronicles of a Crime Scene Reconstructionist. Obviously, as a police officer, you want to see the innocent protected. You want to see the guilty punished, apprehended, and to receive their just rewards. Have shows like CSI, to give the most obvious example, have they made it, in your opinion, more difficult to convince a jury that somebody is guilty because they want a flashy computer program that appears on the screen, and they want something that is bright and shiny that they can be shown? Or has it made it easier to convict because they understand DNA to some degree?
That's a very good question. It's harder to convict, and continually in trials. The Robert Blake case is a good example where I had to explain to the jurors, it's not like you see on television. It is nothing like what you see on television. But our job is, and I told them what our job is compared to what you see on TV. And still, those jurors, it was reported to the prosecutor, Shelley Samuels, afterwards, that the jurors were expecting to see a little bit more what like they see on TV, a little bit more DNA, stuff like that. And that just doesn't exist like TV portrays it. So there's a fallacy out there that's presented by television.
There was a story you told about the Bob Crane murder case, Bob Crane, the actor from
right.
Hogan's Heroes, who had been bludgeoned to death, and you, there was a photograph where there was some parallel marks, some blood marks, and you couldn't quite figure out where they had come from, and it was a girl in one of the classes, a student, who actually deduced what made those blood marks. Have I got that?
You've got it exactly right. It was amazing, and the Bob Crane's body was lying on a bed. He was bludgeoned with a tripod from two cameras that he had in his room, and he was doing dinner theater in Scottsdale, Arizona. And there was this unusual, on his left shoulder, there was a very, very unusual blood pattern and a funny little mark. Well, something made that. I mean, blood just doesn't flow out of a nose and create an unusual pattern. And at the end of the experiments, where they used tripods and stage blood, because and we had two prosecutors there from Maricopa County in Arizona, and we were all questioning, what do you think this is? I didn't know. I mean, here you've got a person, and she's a junior in high school at David Douglas. She says, I think I know. Could I try something? Well, lying next to Bob Crane's body was the item that was used to strangle him, an electrical cord. And the plug at the end of the electrical cord was bloody, and it has two prongs, and that's what the pattern looked like, and she replicated that, and there it was, right in front of us the whole time. Absolutely didn't see it. It humbled you. And I was so proud of her.
And now, with an Outlook Portland editorial reply, Things from Another World presents Magic the Gathering's Thornscape Battle Mage.
People of Portland, among the greatest battles faced by your community, your country, and your world are the battles against prejudice and ignorance. Such conflicts do not always announce themselves for what they are. While prejudice often comes cloaked in a white robe of hatred, it can also come wearing the mask of concern for the community. And this particular brand of bigotry frequently finds as its targets the men and women of our law enforcement agencies. People of Portland, it is all too easy to assign blame based on partial truths, half-understood stories, and only a glancing familiarity with the evidence. The noble men and women of the Portland Police Force serve in the face of danger, of nerve-wracking stress, and the many times unfounded scorn of those they are sworn to protect. Even I, a humble elf wizard, stand in awe of the patrolmen, detectives, investigators, and walkers of the beat who collectively form our greatest defense against the doers of evil. This thin blue line, which protects every color and every creed, asks only for your support, your patience, and your willingness to judge these officers of the law not on gossip or innuendo, but instead to judge them on just the facts. Thank you.
This has been an Outlook Portland editorial reply from Magic the Gathering's Thornscape Battle Mage, brought to you by Things from Another World. Whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection. This, and I really can't overstate how great this book is, and I'm not just saying that. It is in stores now. It is called Blood Secrets, Chronicles of a Crime Scene Reconstructionist. The author is sitting to my immediate right, retired Deputy Rod Englert. We will discuss more about this book and your career and what is next for you when we come back. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. Sorry, I mangled that just there. I said, did you say Chief Deputy?